Hello guys, RoosterGamer420 here and welcome to the long awaited episode 5 of the Bobsy 3D Let's Play. Last time we finished World 2 and started the very first level in World 3, so it's nice. And now we're going to the next level, which is honestly a pretty good level. I don't know what to say about it. It's the first rocket car level called it's Days of Thunder. So without further ado, let's begin. I've been quite busy IRL for a while, so that's why I haven't like uploaded any video in a long time. I have been quite busy IRL, but now that I'm back, let's do this. Oh crap. I first take these woolies out, cause I don't know. I always took these woolies out before getting in any rocket ship. I always felt like they were going to be annoying if I didn't take them out. So now we start riding on the rocket cars. We haven't seen one of these since Catatomic Catastrophe. But now they're put front and center in these levels. One of the things I love the most about Bobsy 3D is that there's only three worlds, but each world has, with the exception of World 1, each world has two unique teams. And the boss level has its own, and every boss level has its own theme. That's really cool. I think that's one of the many best parts of Bobsy 3D. I just freaking love this game, as you may already know. To get the first rocket here, just gotta hop from spaceship to spaceship until you find a platform with a woolly and a rocket. There is a telescope that shows you where the platform is. But I don't use telescopes. I'm not a new player. I don't use telescopes. I've been playing this since late 2020. I already beat this game 50 times. I practically basically memorized the layout of every single level. I overall think this level's pretty cool. Although it's not my favorite spaceship level. It's probably one that I like the least, but still really good. As e everything in this game is, honestly. Now we're going for the second rocket. This rocket car here is from the is for the main path, but we're still missing one of the rocket pieces. So now we should go to here to this little mountain ridge, and be pretty careful with those scringes and smart bombs. Oh crap! If one of these smart bombs targets you, you better start running or jumping, whatever is faster for you, until you're out completely out of the range. As once they start chasing you, they're actually faster than Bobsy running. So overall, they can be quite annoying, but they're not awful. They're not terrible. Just a bit annoying. The worst enemy in the game is probably the Scringe. Those weird snake, slime snake thingies. They're pretty fast. They're not faster than Bubsy running, but they're still pretty fast. And they can only be defeated with atoms. At least the smart bombs die once they attack you. Granted, they don't give any points when exploding, unless killed by Bubsy himself. But at least they die. You can also kill them by shooting their targets. Like this. Oh crap. I think now I will show you a bit more of the stages. The stages. Pretty much a flat terrain with platforms. Kinda like that. I like that. Get a lot of places to see and stuff. Whole levels surrounded by water. All the levels in World 3 are just surrounded by water. Oh! Damn you! Woolly helicopters are like flies, they are super annoying. And this is the very first time we see them, aside from the bonus rounds. There is an extra life near the goal, like below the goal, where the goal is, so should be, I should pay attention to goal, any goal sounds or anything like that. Oh! Here's the goal, and right here's an extra life. Oh crap! I don't know what's up with woolly helicopters. They're always flying too high. They're always flying too high when you try to bop them. And the depth perception in this game is better than the depth perception in most 3D platformers of the at the time. But it's great, it's really good, but not perfect. So now we're going to the main path. Shoot this woolly. Here, there's actually two paths for some reason. Here, there's this path, there's two paths crossing here, this white platform path and this grayer platform path that leads you to the rocket car you have to go to reach the goal. Going up here for an extra life. Cool. We got 100. Now, if we can gather 50 more, we can go to the bonus round as usual. So let's go here. Try to grab as much atoms as possible. Have to crouch here to avoid these hammers. We didn't get 150, but anyways, we have more than enough lives. I barely even die in this game. But I do need Paw Points for the Poly and Esther fight. Spoilers. Endgame spoilers, actually. Right. Now on to the next level. And this level, wait for it. This level is probably my least favorite of the land levels. Or at least it was for a long, long time. If you have ever seen footage of this level in any of those crappy reviews or stuff like that, you may know that this is where critics start saying that the level design becomes overly labyrinthine. For me, it's just this level that it's kinda labyrinthic. But it's not bad. But it can be kind of troublesome for new players. I remember getting stuck on this level a lot during my first couple of playthroughs, like my first and second playthrough, and one thing to note, this level is full of scringes. So let's be very careful. We're definitely going to lose quite some Paw Points here. Another thing to note, if a platform is moving fast, you have to glide onto it once it's coming to you, coming towards your direction. Or else you're going to fall. That tip's going to be useful for the 16th level. And the good news here are that there's another path here. That is way easier to get through as well. I want atoms. I really want atoms. I want all of them. Well, not all of them, because if I were going to get all of them, we will take a very long time, just in one level. But I want to get 150 here. Grab the invisibility. Be careful with the scringes. If you have played this game and Bubsy 1 as well, you'll know that they actually nerfed the invisibility in this game. And now you can't go through enemies in this game using the invisibility. Now this is a pretty good trial and error challenge, but it's actually pretty easy if you know how to control this game, obviously. Pop off, and right away there's a scringe. That's cool. $400,000 points. Nice. We're already reaching 100, so we can probably get to 150 if we continue doing this. If I continue this way. Oh, crap. Oh. That kind of scared me, not gonna lie. Let's climb these artificial trees. I think these are artificial trees. They're not plant colored, but they look like trees. But they're not plant colored. And they have like these white gray platforms, standard white and gray platforms on top of them. So they're definitely not natural. Overall, this level looks like a sort of ghost town, or either a ghost town or a contaminated city, or a polluted city. It kind of looks polluted. But hey, that's just a plus they like the industrial things. But hey, that's just a theory. A game theory. It might be polluted, but that's just a game theory. Another of these annoying guys. Got a 10 shot. Now, we obviously have to find the propeller. Or the fan, or whatever you want to call it. The game calls it propellers. I personally call them fans. That's why I kinda hate woolly helicopters. That what you saw right there is why I kinda hate woolly helicopters. I think we're good to go here. Yeah. Now, you normally go to these white platforms and land on the switch, but I know as you during my, due to my 50 playthroughs of experience, I know a little trick. That's why I wanted another thing we're going to do is why I wanted the 10 shot. Yes, 150. Get onto the water strider. These are officially called paddle creatures, but like just like fans, I mean propellers. I just call them water striders. Yes, this is what I've been waiting for. Doing this time on says on the green platform and pick up the rocket right away. Here and finish the level. And we get to the bonus round. And if I remember correctly, yeah, This is a gliding bonus round. These are honestly my favorite types. My favorite kind of bonus round. Oh. Dang it. And now, next level is one of my favorites, like in the entire game. Yeah, I have a lot of favorite levels in the game, in this game, because I just adore this game as a whole, as you may already know. Run away, Wooly, let's go. This is probably my favorite spaceship level. There's another one, being 17th level is another spaceship level. But this is probably my... Damn it. No. Why? 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 Just... Freaking why? Just why? This is humiliation. This is straight up humiliation for me. Damn you. Damn you, water. That was just straight up humiliation. That was humiliating. Horrible, horrible humiliation. But anyways, nothing happened. Nothing really meaningful. We only lost 2 lives and we have like 64 left. So, whatever. Go here. I prefer to kill this smart bomb from here. That's safer than letting it hit you or grab and quicker than faster than grabbing the clambo to kill it. Go down this path, and right here there's a switch that deactivates a cube. That for the longest time I didn't even knew what was it for? Ah, oh, sorry. What was it for? But it turns out it's actually needed to get the second rocket of the level. And boys, we got our lives back here. But we are probably never going to get our pole points back. Or, I don't know, maybe we can. Who knows? Only time will tell. For now, we just kill all the Woolies. Probably going for those plambles later. I don't know how much time I have been recording so far. 31 minutes. Ah, oh, probably not. Yeah, no. Totally not. We have been already 30 minutes here. And besides, though, I already have a lot of extra lives, so it doesn't matter very much. Oh. Now this is the last Simon Says in the whole game. It's 7 steps long. One mistake and it will add another 5 minutes to this episode. One more. Okay. Gotcha. Now we're going to directly get back to that rocket car. It's going to... But we're not going to hop off the last rocket car at the near the big mountain. Yeah, we're not going to hop off this rocket car, and we are going to that mountain, because here's the 10 shot, and there's a breakable wall, you know, there's the first rocket here. First rocket's here, guarded by a single woolly helicopter. If this video ends up getting audio problems, it's because of my headphones. They are kinda busted, but at least they work. Now here you just gotta hop off, grab the rocket. Use all of our items here because there's no walls where the goal is. Touch this little checkpoint. Oh damn. I want them atoms. Come on, I want them atoms. Now, lastly, we just have to ride this rocket car, optionally kill a woolly helicopter right here, and take the platform to the goal. I remember this actually took me a few tries on my very first playthrough. No, we're not getting 500,000. At least not yet. So that will be it for today's episode, guys. Remember, the next episode in the Bobsy 3D Let's Play, we will finally finish the game, get all rocket parts, and hopefully get back to Earth. Although, saying that it's spoilers, saying I'm not going to spoil the ending for those who haven't seen it yet. So, anyways, we have only 3 levels left, so hope to see you later, guys. Bye.